My main complaint with Biden and the uniters is this: uniting is not going to work. How are you going to unite a bunch of nationalists, a bunch of Nazis, a bunch of grimy crony capitalists, liars, cheats, and thieves? How are you going to unite with them, with decent, moral people? How are you going to unite under capitalism when capitalism does not unite? It divides. Capitalism destroys and divides. And no matter who gets raised up by their bootstraps, there's still twice as many, well, 10 times as many, pulled down and left down and kept under the boot. So I don't want to hear about this crossing the aisle shit. Figuratively speaking, it ought to be done with a chainsaw. These cretins in the GOP, in our government, they have to go. And they have to go now because what it has turned out to be is they represent the greedy and the elitist. They represent those sons of bitches that Madison fought for and wrote about in Federalist Papers number 10, where he said that the mob should not have an influence, and therefore we don't need a real democracy. Yes, we do need a real democracy. Yes, we do need one person, one vote. Yes, we do need to abolish the Senate right away. Yes, we do need to expand the House of Representatives and base it on maybe 50,000 or 100,000 constituents. That might be too many. Yes, we do need to have citizens getting involved like they are now in voting. We need citizens to come forward and take part in our country. We need to get rid of this idea that government is bad. There's bad elements in government, and they need to go. And the worst element that's happened in government in the last 50 years is Ronald Reagan. Yeah, Nixon was really bad, but he got rid of himself. Ronald Reagan was enamored by a bunch of fucking idiots. Ronald Reagan was a piece of shit, and he's the cocksucker that ruined everything. Well, pardon my language. That is a good thing. He was not a good thing. He was a shithead. The worst thing about Ronald Reagan probably might have been that Hinckley was a bad shot. Now, the good thing that came out of that was the Brady Bill and gun control. Yeah, that's right, gun control. Yeah, Ronald Reagan. That was a good thing. He didn't do many other good things. No, he did a lot of bad stuff. And he's the reason for the piss poor season we have today economically and the inequality that was extended and increased that we have today. And yes, we need income equality. And yes, we need public housing to a 10 times greater extent than we do now. The public needs to own things, not the government, not even necessarily the government through the public. The public needs to own things through public cooperatives. And the government has to be there to regulate so that these are safe and efficient and not rip-off organizations commandeered by a bunch of thieves, liars, and cheats. So, yeah, why do we have liars, cheats, and thieves today? Because we gave away our freedom. We never really had our freedom. So, all this crap about liberty and freedom and all this other crap is nothing more than just pure bullshit. It's bullshit. We're not as free as we think we are. It's just like this argument about wearing a mask is limiting your freedom. No. That, see, there it is right there. There's the inherent stupidity in way too many of us. It's stupid to think that wearing a mask is bad for you. That's stupid. Number two, it's stupid to think that it doesn't work. There's just so much proof. It's like climate change. It's like a greenhouse gas-induced global warming through man's meddling. And people tried to dispute that. Bullshit. It's the cause. It's the reason it's accelerating. Yes, we've had global warming and climate change throughout the eons. Not millennia, eons. Most of it takes many millennia. This hasn't taken many millennia. This has happened in like 200-300 years. And it's accelerating. So I don't want to hear this bullshit about, oh, it's normal, and the climate goes up and down, and the sun is responsible, and it always happens. It's just part of the natural cycle of things. The only way it's part of the natural cycle is that man is a natural phenomenon on our planet who has induced and accelerated the natural cycle. So I don't want to hear this fucking bullshit about climate change being a hoax. All that is fossil fuel propaganda. All that is capitalist propaganda that brainwashes stupid fucks who don't have the balls to stand up to these people, take them over, and turn companies into worker-owned cooperatives. Yeah, that's the problem. Not every company is going to be a worker-owned cooperative. We're not going to completely eradicate capitalism. We can work with capitalism to make it fair and democratic. Because let's face it, we are in a world capitalist economic system. And let's face it, the Chinese have actually mastered the economics of that system to where they have significantly increased the living standards of the vast majority of their population and workers. No, it's not what we have. It's not what we've had. No, it's not. But it's a tremendous improvement over what they had. And in comparison, it's much more of an improvement than we've made in the last 60 years. So, come on. Wake up, motherfuckers. You know, you don't have to hate, but you can put people in their place. And these right-wing sons of bitches, hey, they are just a tool. They are tool of the capitalist masters of our money and wealth. They are the reason of this goddamn piss-poor season. Now, if you have any fucking intelligence at all, and you do any reading on both sides of the spectrum, you will see that these neoliberal economics, yes, that's right, the school of von Mises and Milton Friedman is wrong. It's totally wrong. There is no fucking free market. That's bullshit. That's another ploy so that the capitalists can keep control. And it's not a conspiracy theory, motherfuckers. It's a goddamn business plan. So you better fucking wake up. You better fucking wake up. Now, even where this is going to be posted is a fucking stupid, fucking illiterate capitalist scheme. And it's owned by guess who is getting, yeah, guess who is getting investigated for antitrust. Yes, that's right. Guess fucking who owns this fucking app and this fucking, I don't even want to get into it. It makes me stutter and stumble. And I don't need to do that. Why don't we make this particular entity people owned? Why don't we make it publicly owned, turn it into a rotating executive board of users. Users who are capable of administering and managing, who don't want a permanent position. That's right. Why don't we do that? Why don't we make this a representative cooperative where everybody has one vote and one say-so? Probably the capitalists would win out, probably, in the beginning. However, if this is regulated properly, and we have true free speech. Now, here's the beauty of free speech. Yeah, we got these hate fucks. We got these white nationalists. We got the white supremacists. We got the chauvinists. We've got all these repressive pieces of shit who don't really want freedom. They want to impose their way of thinking on everyone. And yeah, I want my way of thinking to be in the lead. That's right. I'm not going to impose it, though. I can't. Just like these guys can't fully impose their way of thinking. But through assholes like Reagan, they got to put just little bits and pieces in. Then Obama comes along. Now, hey, the good thing for me about Obama and the reason I voted for him, because I knew it would expose this huge underbelly of these assholes that's been out there for many, many years, probably since the 70s. These assholes have been out there in force. And I knew that they would come to the surface. And everybody's so shocked that we have all this division and we have all this tribalism and we have, oh God, all this disunity. We've always had this tribalism, this nationalism, and this disunity. It's just been laying low. And now since they have the free speech bug, they come out. And when they come out, we get to rip them a fucking new asshole. That's right. We get to say, you guys are doing some wrong, bad, evil shit, and you gotta go. And how do we do that? We consistently, powerfully present the facts and the true side of the other side of the story. Listen to those words there, because it requires a lot of discernment, of which another synonym for that is caution. In closing this, I'm going to tell you that capitalism is the reason things are fucked up. And it's not, you know, pure good capitalism. It's capitalism gone awry by the greedy and the thieves. So that's what it is. And this is where this I don't want to pay taxes shit comes from. I know what it's like not to want to pay taxes. I didn't want to pay taxes in the greatest income producing portion of my career. No, and I paid the price for that. Not that that was right or that was wrong. We have to pay taxes. It's civic responsibility. We have civic and community responsibility. Each one of us that lives, works, and is a part of, even retired in, a community. That's right. And the dedication of service to the community is at an all-time fucking low up until now. Finally, people are getting out in, by the millions and voting. Now, they might vote that prick back in, and if they do, we are really fucked, because it shows how poisoned and how inept the majority of our people are. It also shows the inequity in our system. As I said, the Senate has to go, and the House must be expanded. And executive power must be held tightly in check. And probably SCOTUS needs to go away as having the final say-so on the legal aspects of our country. Maybe we need a civilian SCOTUS which reflects the views, wants, and needs of the majority of the people which contribute to their common welfare. Maybe we need that. So, you know what? This unity crap is bullshit. It's bullshit. We've never had it. We don't have it. That's part of the nightmare they call the American dream.